Hello, this is Cristi. Just a quick update on Camtasia. They have just added a new feature, only on the Mac, I'm afraid, at the moment. So they're keeping with this tradition of releasing features without doing it for both OSs. I suppose, you know, I hope this is coming soon for Windows. But there's a new feature that's been requested for a long time by Camtasia users, and that is to allow them to put stroke or outline on text. So before now, you could do outlines to annotations, and that was pretty much all of it. You couldn't do an outline for text. And a lot of people have asked for that. So now this is possible to do with a couple of asterisks, like, you know, half-baked, you know, it's not really completely done properly, but it's going in the right direction. So let me just show you. I am on Camtasia 2023 for the Mac. So this is Camtasia 2023 1.2. So this is the update that has this feature. So I'm just going to show you how it works. You can add an annotation with some text. I'm just going to put some text in here, and I'm going to make it quite large. Here we go. And I'm going to make it red. Doesn't matter what it is. And you know what? You could do a bold text just to show the effect there. So I have my text in here. How do I add the stroke or outline to it? Fine, you go to Visual Effects and you find the border effect. So border, you could add it to the object like this and nothing happens so far, okay? So obviously the border is probably now applied to the whole annotation, as you can see it right there. I'm changing the thickness. But the new option that was added right now is to tick this box, Use Alpha. And when you do that, there you have it. The outline is applied to the text, not to the text box. Okay, so the text lives in a box or a frame, and then you can obviously add border to that. But now this is applied to the text, and you can change the thickness. Of course, you can make it very thick, very thin. So there you go. And you can also change the color, because you change the color of the border. I'm going to make it green or white or whatever. So that's how you do it. Now, the only downside, again, like I said, is not really properly done, is the fact that you can't have now just an outline without coloring inside of the text. At least I couldn't figure out how to do this, because if I change the opacity of the whole thing disappears. If I go to the color of the text, there is a way to change the color. Of course, you can change the color in here. Let's make it green, but I don't have a way to make the color transparent, okay? So the only way that I can think of right now is to make a copy of this without the borders and use an alpha invert on it with the media mat. So let me just show you. So this is the text that I am trying to make it be transparent, right? So since I can't remove the color green, yeah, because the opacity removes everything and the color doesn't have a transparency control, then my only choice is really to make a copy of this text, make sure it's in the same exact position. I'm going to make this one red just to distinguish it from the other ones, or pink. And I'm going to, on this copy, I'm going to go and remove the border effect from it. I can still see the border from the one below it. But now look, if I move this, you can see that this purple, this raspberry color, I don't know what it is, doesn't have that border, right? So Command Z or Control Z, Command Z really, because this is not for the Windows yet. And now I can apply a media matte effect to this annotation. So media matte to the clip on top, and change the media matte mode from alpha to alpha invert. So there you have it. Now I have removed, I've hidden that color of the text. So I can just select both of these, group them, Command G or Control G on Windows, and then they will be moved as a single object. And of course, you know, if you want to change the text, you have now the option to treat this as an asset with quick properties. You can go here to the quick property editor and connect these two text fields, link them together, so that if you want to change the text, all you need to do is just change one. So let me change it here to Cristi. This is my name. Boom, I have text with outline only. And to demonstrate that it's really transparent, let me just add another annotation, like a rectangle with a different color behind my text. So I'm just going to put this rectangle there, and I'm going to make it, I don't know, some kind of blue, and move it at the bottom There you have it. So now my text has just the outline. So this is one workaround. Again, with the workarounds, you know, a lot of Camtasia users kind of find workarounds, you know, because there are things that Techsmith hasn't implemented, so we got to do our job, right? So there you go. This is my text with outline. Very simple to do. I'm afraid at the moment only on the Mac. I can only hope that it comes on Windows soon. So, you know, that whole thing, Mac and Windows, they're not the same. Parity, feature parity, it's not there yet on Mac. And I actually have a whole video coming soon about all of the differences between Mac and Windows when it comes to Camtasia. It's like they're two different products. Anyway, so here we go. I hope this was useful. This is in, again, Camtasia 2023.1.2 for Mac only. Let's hope it comes on Windows. Thanks for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and check out the links below for the way to support me if you want to support me. And, you know, see you on the next one. Thank you.